He says he will hurt Daddy if he comes home. Tommy really likes you, Mommy. My 6-year-old daughter has had an imaginary friend ever since she was 3. We moved into a new house not long after her 3rd birthday, and that's when it started. At first, my husband and I thought it was a clever way to get extra dessert or snacks, since she would always ask for extra for Tommy. We'd humor her and give it to her, and each time it would be eaten. We always thought she just had a big appetite, although she's always been a very small girl. The only thing about Tommy was that we were never in the room when he was present. I'd hear her talking to herself in her bedroom, and when I'd approach her room, it was as if she was shushing him. The first odd thing I noticed when my daughter was sick. My husband works away from home, so I take care of her by myself most of the time. She absolutely could not keep anything down, not even water. Her doctor told me that it was a virus that she'd most likely caught from school, and it would clear up in a couple of days. She was in bed watching a Disney movie and she called me from her room. I rushed in, thinking she was going to vomit again, but she looked up at me like she was going to fall asleep any second and said, "Mommy, can I have a snack?" I knew she couldn't keep anything down. I asked her what she wanted and if she was feeling better. She said she wasn't feeling better, but she needed a snack. I went to the kitchen to get some fruit for her and handed it to her. "Thank you, Mommy. You can go now." I looked down at her, bewildered, and she half smiled at me as I stood up and left the room. I knew for a fact that she was not going to be able to eat it. She couldn't even look at food for a long time before she was throwing up. I waited around 10 minutes and went back into her bedroom to check on her. She was fast asleep, and the apple I gave her was gone. The core was not on her nightstand. I slowly lifted her blanket to see if she'd fell asleep with it in her hand, but it was nowhere to be found. I absolutely could not wrap my mind around it. The next 2 days were hell for her, as she just did not seem to be getting better at all. But by the 3rd day, she walked into the kitchen like her normal, perky self. I asked if she was feeling better, and she said she felt fine. I got her some breakfast, and we sat down to eat. "Hey, Mommy." She looked up at me from her cereal. "Do you know Father Sanderson?" "I sure do, honey." I smiled down at her. "He's been around since I was a young girl." "Why do you ask?" "I was talking to Tommy about how he comes into school some days to teach us about God and Jesus." She shoveled a spoonful of cereal into her mouth. "Oh, he does. That's nice." I pushed her hair back off her face. "Hum, Tommy says he ducks my teacher Mrs. Withers when Mr. Withers is away." She said so nonchalantly, as if it was a casual thing to mention over breakfast. I almost choked on my cereal. "Paris." I yelled, "What in the world? Where did you learn that?" She looked at me, as if she knew she'd said something wrong. "Where did you hear that? Don't lie to me." I turned her head to face me. "Tommy told me. I just said that." She looked up at me with those eyes of hers, and they started to tear up. I hugged her and told her she wasn't in trouble, but not to talk like that again. She agreed, finished her breakfast, and I got her ready for school. After I dropped her off, I went to work and tried to forget about it. That night was eventful. I made dinner in Paris, and I sat down to eat. I mentioned how her dad was coming home in a couple of days, and asked if she was excited to see him. She shook her head. "He can't come home." She looked at me in some sort of panic. "He can't. He can't." Her eyes filled with tears, and I picked her up and hugged her, asking what was wrong. "Tommy doesn't like Daddy." She looked at me sadly. "He wants to live with just us two. He says he will hurt Daddy if he comes home. Tommy really likes you, Mommy." I assured her that nobody was going to hurt her father, but she insisted that something bad will happen if he return home. "Tommy says he's a ducking dirty cheat." She cried. I scolded her for the language and told her not to talk about her father like that. Soon after, I was finally able to settle her in bed and she fell asleep with no issues. I lay awake for hours thinking about what she had said. I was considering sending Paris to a therapist to see if they could get to the bottom of this. My husband returned home late a few nights later, and after spending some time filling him in on the events, we decided that we would call the therapist the next morning. We headed to bed, and I went to shower before joining my husband in bed. When I walked out of the bathroom, Paris was stood right outside the door, eyes wide and arms crossed. I almost jumped out of my skin and asked her what she was doing up at that time, and she just stared at me. I knelt in front of her, ready to pick her up and take her back to bed, when she took a step back, snapped her head to the side so fast and whispered, "Tommy is mad, mommy." I picked her up and took her into her bedroom. I put her in bed and covered her up. "Now you stop this," I said sternly. "Listen to me, Tommy is not real." She sat up in her bed and held her hand to my mouth. "Don't say that, mommy. You're going to upset him." I pulled her hand away and stood up, walking out of her room and switching the light off. Before I closed the door, I heard her say she didn't mean that, Tommy. Please don't hurt her. When I went into my bedroom, my husband was already asleep. I figured I would fill him in the morning and try to sleep myself. Surprisingly, I fell asleep quickly and awoke to find my husband still asleep next to me with the blanket over his head. I got up quietly so I didn't wake him and walked out of the bedroom. My heart felt like it was in my mouth as I saw writing on the wall in what looked like blood that said, "I am real." I screamed and ran into my daughter's room, pulled her out by her hand, and asked her why she did this. She cried and told me it was Tommy. I'd had just about enough and ran into my room to wake up my husband. I pulled back the blanket and was met with my husband lay on his side, eyes open with his throat slit. I screamed and cried until my lungs burned. I heard a small voice coming from the doorway of my bedroom. "I told you he was mad." I turned around quickly and saw Paris holding her bear and staring at her father's corpse. I picked her up and ran downstairs to grab my phone and call the police. I grabbed my daughter, who at this point I was convinced murdered her father, and blamed her imaginary friend, and ran outside to wait for the police. When they arrived, I tried to explain the situation as best I could to the officers who questioned me, while others were inside with my husband. They asked Paris questions, to which she answered confidently about Tommy, and the officers looked suspicious. One of them looked down at my daughter and asked where Tommy was at that moment. She replied, "Under my bed, that's where he sleeps." The officers entered my house, and I heard some commotion before a scruffy-looking man was dragged out of my house in handcuffs. He was shouting my daughter's name and telling her he loves her and that he will see her again one day. The officers explained that he was in fact under my daughter's bed, and he had been living in our house without mine or my husband's knowledge, but to the knowledge of my daughter. When questioned, he admitted that he was living in the house when it had been empty, and when we moved in, he'd been sleeping under her bed and using the bathroom slash shower whilst I was in work and my daughter was in school. He never hurt my daughter, and he killed my husband because he was apparently cheating on me during his time away for work. Tommy claimed to have used my husband's laptop during the time he spent around my house and saw messages and pictures from my husband's lover as his phone was synced with his laptop. He claimed to be in love with me and would have done anything for me. Today, I received a letter from him claiming that when he gets out of prison, he will see us again, and we will be a family. For now, Paris and I are moving on with our lives. We are both waiting for the day that Tommy is released from prison and comes for us. It's not every day you find someone that will kill someone for betraying you because they love you so much. Just a few more years and we really will be a family. Thank you for watching. Hit like and subscribe. For more videos,